you'd like to be in the audience for the Fred Jackson Show, it's live Mondays at 7. You just go to www.wbbz.tv, click tickets or the Fred Jackson icon. You need to make reservations. They go very quickly. Last night we had a sold-out audience, Canisius High School football team here. So if you'd like to get here to be a part of the show, make sure you go online and sign up. We have Steve Manchin, the hockey man, with us, and we've been talking to this a little bit about the dilemma of the Buffalo Sabres. I want to shift gears just a bit because last Friday was a historic day. I've been around a long time.
Yes, you
longer
have.
Than you. Maybe. I was there at the news conference
right.
out at the AdPro Training Center. I have never been in the room with all of the VPs of the Buffalo Bills and all the VPs of the Buffalo Sabres together. And that's what was out there, and then some. It was a historic day. The Pegulas seemed too good to be true. They've certainly put their money where their mouth is.
Absolutely.
Now, having said that, there's obviously still huge question marks, and some of the local writers point out their success with the Buffalo Sabres has been abysmal on the ice. From a business community, they're doing great things. The Harbor Center is going to be a tremendous facility, and you can't give them enough credit.
Yep.
Now they're stepping into the NFL, which is much bigger than the NHL. I think Terry Pegula's already found that out. He was already on TMZ. They were making fun of his sneakers and his pants that he was wearing at the game Sunday.
Right.
That doesn't happen to NHL owners.
No,
nobody cares.
Nobody knows who they are, most of them.
How do you think they're going to adjust to this, Steve?
Well, I'm sure they'll handle it just fine. Again, it'll be an adjustment. I mean, you talk about it being historic. Well, how many team people that own NHL teams and own NFL teams? I mean, it just doesn't happen.
There are no other.
No,
right?
I mean, as I said to a friend of mine who roots for a team down to plays at Madison Square Gardens, does your owner own an NFL team? it's a great situation. But again, I could, I love the fact they're building Harbor Center and investing everything. I want to see it on the ice. My God, how many years we have to put up with this, and it's time to get this team turned around. Same way with the football team, 14 years without playoffs?
Yeah, going on 15.
You own a team, it's a trust. And the trust is to put a competitive team on the field, on the ice, and compete for a championship. And I know every time they buy a team, the Sabres and now the Bills, we're here, we're going after Stanley Cups, we're going after Super Bowls. Hey, that's what I want to see. That's what I want to be part of as a fan, as a person that's lived his entire life in Buffalo. I think the passion for sports in this town is unbelievable, but it's starting to wear a little thin.
You made mention one thing. I think one thing that undoubtedly will happen now that they control both the stadium, Ralph Wilson Stadium, and the football team, they'll have an outdoor game. They'll have a winter festival, whatever. What do they call it?
Outdoor winter classic.
Winter classic.
Yeah.
The last one was, I think, 10 years ago.
In fact, Kim Pegula brought it up, according to Gary Bettman, that the fact that it is going to be the 10th anniversary coming up next year, and they should celebrate it by having a game. Yeah, why not? There hasn't been, there's been a lot of great outdoor games, but there hasn't been one as successful as the first one. I mean, that game was perfect. You had snow flurries. You had 70,000 people there. You had a game that went to a shootout, and it was just a marvelous, marvelous day.
You were at the game, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah. What, Sidney Crosby scored the winning?
In the shootout? Yeah.
You couldn't write a script better than that.
No.
Well,
and the snow's coming down,
yeah.
and the lights, and it was just great. Of course, I froze my tushy off, but other than that.
Yeah. I was talking about this to somebody just today about the fact that, you can have all the money in the world, you can buy professional football teams, to get lightning in a bottle and have the formula to be a champion is so, so elusive, it's so tough. The Bills had their shot at it in the early 90s. You had a dominant defensive football player in Bruce Smith, you had a dominant offensive player in Jim Kelly. They had the right formula. The Sabres came awful close, in 99.
Twice.
You had the best goaltender possibly in the history of the game on your roster. They had a shot at it.
Yes, they did.
Those opportunities for those types of players don't come along, which is why I think everybody's hoping that they stumble and bumble and, get Colin McDaniel or
down in my McDavid. Fan cave, down in my basement, I have a pennant from 64-65 Buffalo Bills. I was there for the 64 one. Watched the 65 on TV.
Wow, you were there for that game?
Absolutely.
Jeez, I was born in 69. people tell me stories about it, but you know what I'm talking about.
I'd like to say that I'm one of few people. I'm sure there's many more, and there's many more that probably claim they were, that was at the very first Buffalo Bills game and the very first Buffalo Sabres game. I want to win a championship.
Yeah.
I know I'm saying I want to win a championship. We need to win a championship in this town. You know, how many years do we have to go without one? So we had two with the Bills in the AFL days. We've had two Stanley Cup finals, 75 and 99, and we were close, but no cigar.
Back to the NHL, there appears to be now with the with the draft coming here, and we've got some world tournaments coming here, mm-hmm. and we've got the combine coming here. There seems to be a real love affair between the NHL and the Pegulas and Buffalo. I mean, unprecedented.
Well, yeah, I would have to say, I mean, I'm sure the NHL is just absolutely thrilled with the fact that the Pegulas are now an NFL owner. I mean, that, you know, the prestige and putting that on your mantle and your paperwork there at the NHL. And the fact is, let's be honest, every event that we bring here to Buffalo is usually extremely well attended. The best World Junior ever held in the United States was held in Buffalo. The NCAA Frozen Four was an outstanding event. Record money that they made in that tournament and everything. Having now the combines coming here, which is not an event that's really open to the public, but I'm sure they'll find some ways of doing it. But you've now got a wonderful addition to the First Niagara Center. You're able to have different events tied in. The hotels down there, you're going to have two of them right across the street. You got another one going up somewhere down that's opening next week. And
well, the hotels are key because the NHL is not going to come to a facility in a city.
Yep.
They can't accommodate, you know, all of the owners and all of their entourage, mm-hmm. and all the players and all the sponsors. And more hotel rooms means that's, available to Buffalo. And that Harbor Center being attached to the facility, I think, is significant.
Well, that's what's going to make bringing the World Junior back here so successful. And let's be real honest. When they bring the NCAA in, you know, a lot of the suburban hotels are full, too. Well, there'll be a lot more downtown, a lot more things to do downtown when they bring the basketball back in. And hopefully the Frozen Four is not going to be far behind before we get awarded one of those again. It's a great time for Buffalo hockey and for Buffalo sports. And when they do build a new stadium, I'd be very surprised if it isn't built right down there.
Yeah, so. I think so. John Comel said it on this show last week. The first game in the Harbor Center will be Halloween night.
Yep.
Ohio State, hosted by Canisius.
Yep.
And so it'll be exciting times. And Steve, we'll all be a part of it.
I was in that place a few weeks ago, and it is a fun-looking place, old barn style.
Let's reiterate what we said at the top.
Yep.
West New York Hockey Magazine is coming back.
Coming back. John Comel and the Harbor Center will be on the front page along with other stuff. A lot of good local hockey, and it's going to be out there in the community. And you can check us out at WNYHockeyMagazine.com. It's just up. It's under construction. It's going to be improving over the next week or so. And take a look at
it. It's exactly like the Harbor Center.
Yep.
It's still under construction.
Still under construction.
Steve Manson, he'll be back talking more hockey down the road. We'll be back to wrap up all sports, West New York, right after this.